Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? This will be a seriously fun week to watch the moon. On June 10th, our natural satellite is 2 days past new, so a very slim crescent hangs low in the sky not long after sunset. And because the moon travels near the ecliptic, that being the same line in the sky where the sun travels, close to where the planets do, it happens to be passing by the line-of-sight view of Mercury and Venus that evening. Despite being brighter at around magnitude negative 7, Venus may be easier to spy first, as its negative 4 magnitude point in the sky is difficult to miss. Both should start appearing around 30 minutes past sunset, and once you spot Venus, just look 8 degrees away in this direction for the slim moon phase. Be sure to train a telescope at it too, as the craters Berosus and Hahn, which you can see deeply shadowed here, are visible this evening. You'll need to look quickly too, as the setting moon will be dropping lower in the sky, forcing you to view through more atmosphere, which may mar your view. If you look a day later, those two craters are still visible, but not nearly as well shadowed. They are easy to spot though, just north of the large Mare Crisium, the dark-floored, lava-filled region located here. At 74 kilometers across, Berosus is decent-sized and has a flooded plain that filled with lava billions of years ago. It is named after a Babylonian priest from around 270 BC who noted the locked rotation of the moon. The libration of the moon is such that we can also see the most northern limb edge on the 13th. You really are peeking around the corner here. Look on the northern side, starting at the pair of craters Atlas and Hercules. Moving out towards the limb is Endymion, and practically on the limb, but just inside it this week, is the difficult to see most any other time, Mare Humboldtianum. This feature is over 35,000 kilometers square in area, which is larger than the country of Belgium. Lunar X, coming up next. And now this week's dark sky fact. Replace typical incandescent post-lamp bulbs with silvered ones. Look at the substantial improvement from this one simple change. More info at eyesonthesky.com. By the weekend, the moon is nearing first quarter phase, and for the Americas and Europe, it is ideally placed for viewing the Lunar X and Lunar V features. For North America, the timing of the Lunar X is not terribly ideal as it occurs during daylight hours, but as you can see from this video I took last year, it is possible to see the X during daytime. So starting at 1900 hours universal time on the 15th, which is 3 p.m. Eastern and 12 p.m. Pacific time, the X begins to appear along the terminator. That is the line separating the lighted portion from the unlit area of the moon facing us. An hour later, the X has increased in size and brightness, but the best view is probably an hour and a half after that, at 2130 hours universal, 530 Eastern, and 230 Pacific. If you look about a quarter of the diameter of the moon north along the terminator, you can also spot the lunar V around the same time, though maybe just a little bit later. It's a feature that's visible near the crater Euchart and Mare Vaporum. The Lunar X only lasts about 4 or 5 hours, so be sure to look at the appointed times. And now an observing tip. No neutral density filter? No problem! Reduce the moon's comparative brilliance at the eyepiece by setting up near some outdoor lighting, which will keep your eyes from dark adapting and avoiding them hurting while doing lunar observations. Venus and Mercury are still playing tag near the horizon in the evening, while Saturn sits at nearly due south as darkness falls. Catch all three this week if your skies cooperate. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.